So, we're going to do it now. At least I think we are. Here we are. We are going to be playing some Valkyria Chronicles. For those of you who do not know what this game is a World War II style game. If you know, it's based on a continent called Europa. This is a weird game, just by the sense of it. And I'll be quiet for cutscenes. So,
Miss Melkiot. There's no other sign of the enemy.
Good. Now, go keep watch and stay alert.
Yes, ma'am. What should we do with the bodies, ma'am?
We'll bury them. So it's begun. I'll do whatever it takes to protect the people of this town. I'll do it. Even going to war, I'll do it. What are those?
Seeds from the lion's paw. It blooms white, small, simple, and strong.
I want to be able to remember, once the war is over, that it wasn't all just people killing people. That even in war, there was also new life.
On the 15th day of the third month of the year 1935, the Empire began its assault in earnest. A formal declaration of war was made upon Gallia. Though it was only a small front in a massive continental assault, what followed would prove that a tiny nation could best a military giant. These events would tell a story of tragedy hidden in the mists of time. A story of courage and of trust, of persecution and hate, and of love blooming even through the flames of war. What follows is a record of this conflict and of those who fought, lived, and died.
Excuse me. And so it begins. War. All right.
Chapter 1. In defense of Bruel.
So this game is about a war. Damn it, Faith, but actually, get on Discord, Faith. We're gonna discuss about war. In the continent of Europa, in which war has broken out between the Federation versus the Empire, and Gallia is the country that's been stuck in the middle, and nobody knows why. I need a response. But this war, what it's really about, I mean, this section, because this is just one country defending itself from a huge empire, and it does a bunch of random, like, you know, anime tropes, but it's really a really good strategy game. I played it on the PS3. It was a good game. And I never finished it, and I'm hoping to finish it here, but we had to start from the beginning. So, in the Defense of Bruel, Chapter A1, 1A.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing that old mill spinning again really makes it feel like home sweet home.
I hear that. It really is one of the most beautiful things about this town. Well, citizens, our enemy can't be far behind. I thank you for your help. Goodbye, and take care.
There's a lot of story in this game. I keep forgetting about that. But the entire story is based around...
How's the packing coming along, East?
God damn it.
Almost done. I only need to take the everyday basics.
Well, the Empire's got to be close by. Let's hit the road by sundown.
Martha, look! Welks is here!
Oh, welcome back, Welkies.
You're still calling me that? Martha, I'm 22 years old. And more important, you shouldn't be running around. Aren't you due any day now?
Ah, a light jog won't hurt the little spud. I should know. I've already
So I heard a rumor that you were playing Girls und Panzer, the video game.
Well, it's not. It could be. Could be.
Hello there.
Wife who's in it.
Is Welkin in?
Apparently.
Oh, hello, Alicia.
Let's just make this weird. There's a bread girl, there's a guy who likes to draw animals,
really?
And there's a racist.
I work at
so
the
basically
bakery.
The Hunger
well,
Games.
I did until the war started anyway.
Yes.
Also, you realize more weirder
myself,
isn't a word,
so the flavor's
right?
Guaranteed.
Yes,
best you ever had.
It's like a Kurt Angle word.
Thanks.
Probably.
Do you want to come in?
Because he raps more better.
But his body is splendid when wrapped in leather.
Arrested
I mean, you're not
and
wrong.
Shot at? You've had a busy day of it, haven't you, Welkies?
Jeez, I forgot how annoying this bitch was. The pregnant one.
And what a lovely lady you are for all that adventure.
I'm not sure if she dies
what?
Or not.
You love all the annoying ones, though.
Wait, no, it's not like that.
I mean, you do love Audrey.
He's right. Although I'm
well,
really
Honey
hoping
Pop
to be
Honey Pop was that one game that I played and I regretted every moment of it.
Good. That's how life should be. Secretly regretting Honey
yep.
Pop, but still playing it.
It was taken before I was born.
But to get the understanding of this game,
my father,
there are
Tamer.
People with like purplish hair.
Wait a minute.
They are called the Drarksons.
But I thought
the
general
is
their
race,
was your dad.
And people hate them to the point that I think this war had something to do with that.
My birth parents died when I was a baby.
Well, that's step one.
And there's this one
yeah.
that's like
we're not
the,
related
guy, the
by
main
blood,
character's sister,
she's definitely...
but they're not related, but they don't do anything.
Sorry. No. Yeah.
And which class are you playing as?
The main characters are both scouts, but I prefer playing as a shock troop because they just run in, shoot, leave.
I don't like scouts. I prefer playing as the heavy class or the pyro.
True.
Although that double jump does come in handy.
Yeah. I forgot how much story the first parts of the game are. There is no actual fighting until, like, later on.
Wow, look at this. Brule's really becoming a ghost town.
They've been leaving for a while. Just about everyone is evacuated by now.
You should put out your address, like, on Twitch, so that everyone can send you pizzas.
No,
we'll
I don't want to get
swatted. The town watch will guard and protect
Why not?
It's not as fun as you
Your dad would appreciate that.
Safe again, right?
Mm-hmm. No, he will have a heart attack. Like he had twice.
So, Welkin, I'm curious. Are you going to join
I
the army
like, it's
like
worth
your father?
It.
I don't think that's for me. What I'd really like to do is be a teacher.
Huh. A teacher?
Yeah. Animals and insects, flowers.
And just remember,
plants,
if he has another heart attack, he's just gonna blame you.
I've learned a
he's
lot.
Blamed me
nature.
For the past two.
You see, my dad,
What did you do?
I don't even remember. It wasn't even anything. Like, he had a heart attack, then blamed me. I wasn't even in the room.
He found out you ate the duck sauce packets and had a heart attack.
You know what I mean?
We should redo that video with everyone in it.
Just everyone there. So we gotta find Grant, Adam, me, you, Tanner.
The one that calls me a weirdo.
Who was that?
What was that? I don't know, probably Sam.
That sound.
I don't remember. It may have been horseback number two.
Oh. People are dying now. A terrorist attack has just happened.
You know, I saw horseback number two. Actually, you were there when I saw horseback number two. He was working at the Taco Bell.
Yeah.
I forgot you were there.
So, Joe, if you are watching, remember, this is a war. This is supposed to be Germany.
Don't worry, Saul. I'm not watching.
I know nobody is.
Salva Doom. I don't want to keep your anonymity online, but I feel like it's already been shattered.
It's been shattered since the first stream.
Shattered like the memories in my Silent Hill games.
Well, let's forget. This game has a lot of characters, but we must not forget about Scout Troop Number 1. I do not feel good. I'll explain the mission.
I don't feel good either.
Don't we all?
I gotta pick up my Bob in like an hour, so I gotta start feeling good.
Okay. I gotta shoot people. That's what war is, right?
War never changes.
War never gets more kawaii.
War never suit getting Russia.
We'll play as everyone's favorite troop, the Town Watchman.
Lubu?
No, the Town Watchman. If I could play as Lubu, I would have already done it.
I thought you would have picked Han Dong. Because if Lubu's an option, then Han Dong's had to be an option too.
I forgot how to play this already, Jesus Christ. Nobody in this game wears helmets except for the Town Watch.
They're prepared.
It's like everyone wears this, like this real armor. Yet they don't wear helmets, and the one guy that doesn't actually have armor, he wears a helmet. Now. Oh, Jesus Christ. Don't worry, Joe, I'll eventually play Panzer Madels again.
My turn, okay?
Good, I spent good money on that.
How much was it?
Like $15-$20.
Jesus.
I did it just for you.
Is it because you know I have a thing for tanks?
Yes.
And by a thing for tanks, I mean I want to drive a tank into a town and just demolish everything that they have.
Yes.
Because war never changes.
Until it does.
Then you're like, whoop, I got nothing better to do.
It's war chain.
Time to get the rocket launcher. Now. Joe, you actually might like this game if you actually played it and disregretted everything you played.
What?
You actually like this game if you actually played it and then regret it.
No, I understand what you said, but I don't understand why.
That's the point. Like, this game makes you, like, think, like, wait, what's going on again?
Something about little girls?
No, something about war. And teenage girls.
And little girls.
No, they're all technically the age of, like, I think there's a 12-year-old in this game.
That's little.
Joseph Kony would be proud.
I don't think that's true.
Wouldn't you be proud?
My turn, okay?
No.
Wouldn't you be proud that you're at war, in war?
No.
Oh, wait, that's Tanner, never mind.
Tanner's more concerned about a gentleman's duel.
Like the one that you watch on 205 Live, which you get our recap on our podcast, the You Can't You Handle This podcast. On youtube.com/ Can't You Handle This podcast.
No.
I don't think it's slash podcast. I think it's Can You Handle This cast, but I may be wrong.
Aren't we all wrong?
On the inside.
Have you ever watched that show, Liberty's Kids?
That's on in the living room right now.
You have stars then?
Yes.
Oh god, I have that playing in my background.
Take this!
That game made me real. That move. That show made me realize American history is not that great.
Hostile sighted.
It's pretty bad actually.
It's like pretty dark if you really read into it.
I mean, you're not wrong. Can I just say something?
Yes.
I hate Heel Neville.
We all do. It makes no sense.
He's so boring.
It's like, oh, you hate me because of my accent. Like, no, none of us hated you for your accent because you never spoke.
And he wrestles so slowly, and his finisher's a superplex. It's like he's from the 40s.
Well, remember the old-school wrestling...
ready to go.
The old-school wrestling idea was that the heels have to wrestle more aggressively and they can't do their flips anymore.
Hostile sighted!
But just because you have to wrestle aggressively doesn't mean that you have to go slow as dirt. Baron Corbin's pretty fast. I think Baron Corbin wrestles faster than Neville does.
But then again, Baron Corbin is the most metal athlete of the year.
Moving out.
And everyone hates on Baron Corbin. I like the guy.
He's a good wrestler.
Seems like he's trying to get better.
Yeah, like apparently there was a thing where he wrestled Kane a lot for a while, but I think it was for him to like being like a better worker in the ring, using Kane as like a backup.
Yeah, and he had the thing with Kalisto as well.
Which I like the character, him being a big guy and him being like, I hate little people.
Is it because you hate little people?
No, I'm just hoping the cast from Little People Big World show up on SmackDown and just have Corbin like escort them around.
Is that show still a thing?
No.
We need that little girl that Nikki Bella was talking to just get beat up by Baron Corbin. And then thrown into a tree by Braun Strowman.
You mean Braun Strowman?
Yeah. Him.
But I like what they're doing with Strowman, though. It's pretty good. Like,
from what little I've seen, I like it. I get to start watching more this week.
It's, he's trying to find Sami Zayn, and it got to the point that he just started interrupting match after match. So,
Essentially Samoa Joe.
Yeah. But now what's going on is, I believe Stephanie McMahon is now allowing him to have a last man standing match against Zayn.
Can you imagine Baron Corbin versus Braun Strowman?
The last man standing match? That I'd like to
I'd
see
say,
that.
I'd say make the first man standing match.
What's that? Sounds like a tank.
Oh my god.
Like they start on the ground and the first person to stand up wins.
This could be one of those moments where Sami Zayn just interrupts them, like kicking them to the ground.
He comes on and says, now hold on a minute, player.
We're gonna make this a tag team match, player.
You two versus me and the Undertaker.
Holla, holla, holla.
You know the Mac Daddy.
Oh, as you're saying this, there's a tank just murdering everyone.
Teddy Long is in the tank.
Now hold on a minute, player.
You going one-on-one with the Mach 4 Panzer, player?
Oh. Oh no. Jesus Christ, Joe. The Panzer IV. Holla. Do you even know what the Panzer IV is?
I just kind of made it up. Is that an actual thing?
Yeah, the Panzer IV, and there's several variations of it. There's a Panzer IVD, the Panzer IVH.
Let me Google it real quick.
Those are the only two I know because of World Tanks. But they're both medium tanks, though.
It's a pretty stereotypical tank.
That's like the most widely used German tank during World War II. It was the most versatile, too.
Welkin, tank!
No shit, bitch. There's a tank.
That's not good.
Eat it.
We're not equipped to take out a tank.
Of course you're not. You have a rifle. You're facing a tank. What are you going to do?
Is it an anti-tank rifle?
No.
I hate to say it.
They gotta retreat, though. They gotta retreat. Your town is dead.
The town is dead.
The town is dead. Long live the town. So apparently I can't... Shit. I have to leave, but yeah, I can't let the tank win, even though the tank's like right fucking there.
So I have a question.
What?
Now. On a scale from 1 to 10, how gross was Alexa Bliss's arm?
I saw it, and I kind of thought, like, Jesus Christ, man. Did she just break her arm on live television in front of me?
I hope so.
Here we go.
You know my thing for Alexa Bliss, man. But when I saw
like
that...
all the mean girls.
Yeah, that's the weird thing. Why am I into the mean ones? And I just won. One turn, just one.
Phew. Looks.
If there, we'll try to buy time so everyone can get away.
But what was it? Yeah, La Luchadora. Supposedly, she is
okay.
Nikki.
Okay, I'll head back to my house and grab Isara and Martha, then come back.
Mickey James. Because but she looked black though.
Maybe she got a tan. A really deep.
But
tan.
you know who already has a deep tan. Eva Marie.
But she has black hair.
We didn't see the hair. Mickey James doesn't have black hair anyway. She's got brown hair. What if it's Ember Moon? I feel like she looked kind of like Naomi, though.
Did you check out her ass, though?
Please be okay.
Because... I mean, it could have been very tight-fitting pants.
Yeah, but then again, you need to realize how big.
Martha.
Like how big Naomi's ass. What?
What if it was the other one?
Pregnant or just
Cameron.
She comes back, but nobody cares.
What if it's Ember Moon?
Stop this now.
I'm starting to lean towards Ember Moon. I still think it's Eva, but
it might be one or the other.
See what she's wearing? Take a good look at that shawl. She's a Darkson.
And that explains it. I thought this place stunk.
Oh my god. Now we know it does. One of the guys sounds like the guy from Toonami, the Toonami robot guy thing.
The stinky one. P.U.
Spike Spiegel?
Yes. Farm in here. I forgot his name, that's why.
Spike Spiegel was the character he played in Cowboy Bebop.
I will thank you to watch
his real name is... I don't know, ask Tanner.
We
have to leave
now. We need Tanner on here.
That's a big gun for such a little girl.
Just to get annoyed.
Isara!
Huh? Hold it right there!
He hit a guy with a plank. Die!
Plank from Ed, Edd n Eddy?
I hope so.
Darkson pig!
Racists, every one of them.
Isara, are you okay?
I'm okay, thanks to you. But Martha, I think she's...
Martha!
Damn it, Martha.
She's gone into labor. Moving her would be dangerous.
The bread's on the floor. Somebody think of the damn bread.
We can't just leave her here. What are we gonna do? There are a lot of Imperials.
Are you adopting children again?
It's only a matter of time before they take over the damn bread.
Martha.
Well, listen, the barn out back.
What about it?
Our fathers have left us something. Something that might get us out of this mess.
All are you all right in there?
I think she's pregnant. But then again, she might be just fat.
I think she's dead. But then again, she might just be fat.
That's how it all goes. Oh god, it's a tank!
It's a thunder.
Whoa. I can't believe it's still here.
Supposedly,
here it is.
The guys behind the game, Company of Heroes, added a reskin of the entire game with Valkyrie Chronicles characters.
I wanted to make sure it would still operate, you know, in case of emergencies. I enrolled
in a maintenance
class.
I was so close to buying it.
I wanted to be able to do what my father could do.
Well, that's great.
But then I started buying random shit.
It really didn't need much. Hardly any alterations at all.
Yeah.
I just fitted it with a new turbine engine. It really improves on the power-to-weight ratio.
How the fuck does this bitch know how to fix a tank?
Its firepower and mobility are more than a match for recent models.
Well, assuming it does work.
Like, these are the things I should know about.
Welks, you took the armored vehicle course, didn't you?
Yeah. But you're always there to remind me.
We'll bring Martha here. She'll be safe inside the tank. And we can move to a better location.
Oh, the pregnant woman would be better inside of a tank.
Okay? All you have to do
is
give
her on the front line.
Yeah, give her a gun and a small helmet for the child.
Give her two helmets.
That's to be safe. All these little kids think they're hot shit.
Isara, we ready to roll?
All the little kids and the pumped up kids.
Engaging engine. The Edelweiss is ready for deployment.
Alicia could still be out there dodging bullets, buying time for people to evacuate. Here's the plan. We're gonna pick up Alicia and get out of town.
Oh, so you can't face
Edelweiss.
Everyone's favorite character, the town watchman? Jesus Christ, Welkin, you fucking piece of shit.
Well.
You gotta save everyone's favorite character.
Last week in news today with Saladin.
What?
I'm just looking at your upload. The American Nightmare Cody Bullet Club new member.
Yes. That's how they're billing him, the American Nightmare.
I'm loving your
Photoshop.
Your Microsoft Paint over here.
That's why I put, like, you're the Photoshop guy.
The
you're the really good
operation.
Guy. I'm like, I could barely use MS Paint, but here's the shit.
With Salvadoom.
With Salvadoom. It's just me.
News has a Z in it.
I wanted to put a backward Z because reasons.
Even though in the actual Microsoft Paint edit, it's an S.
Yeah, I'm not that good.
I mean, it's better than nothing. I forgot to upload the last two casts.
Yeah, at least
I'm doing it now, to be fair.
So mine's more actually up
second?
To date.
Don't worry, I'm putting them both up and I'm putting the dates on there.
Alright.
And I'll actually remember next time.
There you go, Town Watchman number one. You're my hero. Don't fail me now, Town Watchman. war. War has changed as much as it should.
War may or may not be changing as we currently speak.
Columbine was an inside job.
Are you sure?
I mean,
that doesn't seem true.
I mean, two students from the school decided to shoot up the school. It was an inside job.
So you think the school was behind an attack on the school?
Yes.
Sound logic if you ask me.
I mean, it's as more logical as ISIS by this point.
And that was the day you lost all of your followers.
If I had any.
You've got two. Tanner's about to unsubscribe.
But personally...
Yeah, I'm about to unsubscribe too.
Alright then.
You're just distasteful, man. I don't like that.
Do I have to make a public apology?
Yeah, you have to go on Twitter and make a Twitter video and tag Zoe Berger.
Moving out.
Of course I have to tag her in it.
Enemy sighted,
even though I'm like 2 feet away from them.
Seems legit.
How the tank's trying to maneuver, like, so... They're trying to, like, get into, like, a perfect angle, and they can't.
Well, they try.
Oh, shit, I forgot to save the goddamn gate. Okay, wait, I have an idea. But it may or may not work. That was a grenade. That was a genade. Hey, he dead.
He dead.
I don't like how I just left the tank there, let them destroy the gate, and that's like the main thing I have to protect.
True.
I ain't no good with tactics.
I ain't afraid of no ghost.
Where's Michael Jackson when you need him?
Well, dead for one.
Do I seriously not have a grenade anywhere? No fucking grenade, alright. Forget how many turns I have to hold out before the tank appears.
Probably 8.
I'm on the second turn and the thing's almost broken.
My turn, okay?
Oh, the one bitch that has the grenade.
Kill him. Kill him like the rest.
I took out the treads at least.
Moving out.
I really hate this process. I have to upload the video to YouTube. Download the MP4 of the video. Edit it with the MP4. Re-upload it. And then enjoy it.
I mean, that's what we get for trying to be podcasters.
That's what I get for trying to run OBS without having any sort of conversion software.
Paddington Bear did 9/11.
What?
I'm just tired by this point. My head hurts. I might have a
Paddington Bear.
I mean, his fuzzy nature, it might be the cause of 9/11.
Was it like a conspiracy with Corduroy? Like, what's going on here?
Corduroy was the other guy.
He was Corduroy was the inside man.
He was the plane driver. He was the plane pilot. Jesus Christ, I want the damn tank already.
I want the government to come out and explain how Paddington and Corduroy did it.
By this point, I'm just tired.
Tired? It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
Hey, the tank driver arrived.
How are you tired? It's 3:45.
Because my head hurts. Entering combat. And I mean, it'll feel good.
The tank should be able to breathe.
I get how a tank works now. Let me drive the damn tank.
Do it. Do it for the vine.
Hostile sighted! Enemy sighted!
Hostile sighted, my lord.
Hostile La Vista.
It's a galleon tank! Alicia!
Welcome!
Her initial reaction isn't, enemy oh, tank sighted we have reinforcements, is, where the fuck did you get a tank?
True.
Do I have a
shot? I mean, that's what I'd be asking too.
End this turn, drive the tank again.
Entering combat!
I need the tank to destroy the other tank. You gotta haul ass before you're gonna haul ass. And the tank stops. This is the inconsistency of this game. A tank could theoretically drive forever, yet it can't.
Well, you gotta run out of gas.
Yeah, that's like the main thing, but it's like, oh, you can only drive like 10 seconds. Oh, great job, you healed yourself. What about the damn wall? Okay, now they're just damage trying minimal. To attack me. Alright, that's good. That's a good thing. Thank you. dead.
I changed my picture on Discord.
I see Faith and it's just nothing. Oh. Oh.
Entering combat!
Do you know who that is?
I don't think we should be friends anymore.
Do you know who that is, Saul?
I don't think we should be friends anymore.
Do you know who that is, Saul?
Yes.
Who is it, Saul? Say his name.
I don't
say
remember
his name for
his
all
name.
To hear.
I don't remember his that's, name.
That's your fun internet friend, Bonzi Buddy.
Oh. I beat the game by blowing up the tank.
Yes! We stopped it!
Well.
Woohoo! Now you're.
Get the fucking
the
gate
Imperials
probably
are running
has
off
about
for
like
now.
30,
looks like we
300
some...
HP.
Welks!
Damn it, Martha.
She gave birth in Dad's tank?
Oh, god damn it. Martha gave birth in the tank.
Well.
If you watch the stream, you can see she gave birth in Dad's tank?
Yes, and without complications. They're both perfectly healthy.
Good. That's fantastic. Now let's stay sharp as we head out of town.
Now they gotta clean that tank. I blame George Bush for this baby being born in a tank.
2 hours after the first shots were fired, Brule was under Imperial control.
Faith.
Though a mere
said
skirmish by Empire standards, the raid on Brule would mark Welkin Gunther's first taste of battle and begin his rise to a Galleon hero.
No.
Why don't you want to download him?
Because I'm playing a war game.
Have him in the corner.
And if I refuse,
I thought I would be
then
ready
I guess,
for this.
We just can't
I knew
be friends.
War meant this might happen.
But you missed it the hurts. Near upskirt, though.
Seeing my town overrun like this, seeing
yeah.
all those people killed, it's just not right. How could all this happen?
Because it's war, bitch. That's what war is.
War. What is it good for?
We look at those birds.
It's good for the infrastructure of our very, very, very favorite company, the military comp.
If anything threatens their home,
military industrial complex.
They'll risk their lives to defend it. People are animals too. We do what we have to when we have to.
Should I download it?
I mean, do you care about your PC?
Animals are in a constant struggle to stay alive, but I've also seen them help each other, almost like they were cooperating in order to survive.
Cooperating?
I mean, not really.
What?
That's why I'm so into studying natural science. That coexistence. I want to know how it works. If we could figure that out, mankind could put it to use for our own survival.
God damn it, Welkin.
That's why
you are not
teacher,
animal, you are person. So you drive tank into building, you blow up children's hospital.
I mean, even if we can't completely eliminate war, at least we might learn to live together as one people.
You think so?
Welks, look. Martha fell asleep, so
that I'm on Reddit
the
asking if Bonzi Buddy
see
is safe.
You,
God damn it, it's a baby.
He's adorable.
We need to give it a helmet
just
and a
like
rifle.
You said, even in war, new life happens all around us. Come here.
That baby's gonna be on the front lines.
Look, that's your hometown.
It's on fire. God damn it.
Someday, we'll come back home again.
I
yes.
like how Welkin shows the babies
someday
that's
soon.
Your hometown as
I
it's on
it.
Fire. Jesus Christ, man.
Acid's on fire.
Chapter 3. Vassal Urban Warfare.
Hey, I think this is the one where you get to pick more people. I hope so. I want to pick my waifu.
Pick a guy.
In March of 1935,
pick a guy.
The Empire began its invasion across Gallia's eastern...
Next.
I get it. War happens. Basically what's happening. The invasion of the Empire, and it nearly capped a lot of it. I don't even know anymore.
Within its walls stood the castle Rand Gris, and within its unicorn spire resided Cordelia, Gallia's princess.
They had a princess, and she's not going to war. That is the wrong type of royalty I want.
Supporting Gallia's policy of neutrality was a system of universal conscription. Under it, all schools required military training each year. In the event of a war, citizens were then drafted into the militia to defend their country. As the conflict with the East grew worse, both Welkin and Alicia found themselves no exceptions to that fate.
War.
What is it good for?
It's good for the infrastructure.
So these are my new digs. Oh, my uniform.
He got a uniform.
I should get changed before reporting in. Better get ready now. Flares, binoculars, a compass, and a map. Everything you need for a nice hike. Or combat.
Welkin? Can I come in?
I like how the first game is a legit war story, while the second game is like a school sim.
Not bad, not bad.
So, basically,
you look good,
that
actually.
One show you watched, Ikitosin.
Yeah, but you know, without the titties.
So, how about me?
Aw.
Do I look alright in this?
No, I don't want to play it.
Let's take a...
It's on PSP.
You look fine.
So you're safe.
You wear it like a pro.
Now I can't
really?
Play.
You're not just saying
unless
that?
You have the emulator like I do.
Now I don't
of course
want
not.
To play
you
it
look
again.
Tough.
Oh, good.
It's better than the Dynasty Warriors
no
games
way.
On
that
emulator.
That plating on the back? It's like a coleoptera exoskeleton.
I think it's better than Dynasty Warriors games in general.
What?
What?
What'd you say about my favorite game series?
Anything.
I'm going to come over to your house with my PS4. We're going to plug it in and then we're going to enjoy our time. Playing Dynasty Warriors.
I thought you were going to use your regular thing. You're going to come over to my house and make a nice dinner.
What?
Usually it's what you say. You're like, I'm going to go to your house. I'm going to make a nice family dinner.
And you're going to fucking enjoy
Coolio,
it.
Julio, what? Did you just
I'm
say
I'm
going to
have
Beetle?
A good time.
Oh, Welkin. He tries to compliment her by saying that she looks like a bug with an exoskeleton.
Same.
What kind of girl wants...
Huh? Not just any bug. A rhinoceros beetle. King of the insects. Who wouldn't want that?
Goddamn.
Uh-huh. I guess I'll just try to take that as a very Welkin sort of compliment.
He needs to stop complimenting people about animals.
You've been wearing it since I met you.
Oh, this? It's part of my uniform from the bakery.
Is that right?
I don't want to forget the time I spent busting my buns baking.
Whoa. Busting her buns.
I plan to keep wearing it until I can get back to manning the ovens again.
That's great. Once you do, I'll be first in line to get some of that bread.
God damn it. These indie windows. He's gonna be first in line to eat some of her bread. Knock,
come
knock.
In. Excuse me, ma'am.
It's Knuckles. I added a new command to the Discord.
Galleon Militia enlistee, Welkin Gunther. Reporting for duty.
Oh,
ma'am.
Exclamation point.
Galleon Militia enlistee Alicia Nakiat. Also reporting for duty.
I'm Captain Eleanor Varratt. Commander of this regiment. Gunther, you're promoted to lieutenant. You'll be leader of Squad 7 now.
Lieutenant
ma'am.
Of Squad 7.
Enlistee Melkiot, you're promoted to sergeant. You'll be under the lieutenant's command. Understood?
Ma'am!
I just sent the link to download Bonzi Buddy into the wormhole.
Nice coincidence, huh, Welkin?
Good.
Valdio? I had no idea that you'd enlisted.
Yep. Now that there's a real war going on, I joined up. Pretty much all the officer and training boys are here just like you.
You know each other?
Yes, ma'am. We knew each other at university. Welkin was in science and I
was in
archaeology.
Here's what some people have sent into the wormhole recently.
And just look at us now.
Bonzi Buddy
no
link.
Archaeology or science.
Gable,
like
Gable.
Two of us are studying
we
war,
are number one.
It's that way.
We will destroy all of you using
you.
High precision long distance macros.
There's a strategy briefing later today.
A
but
YouTube link
time.
Which directs
to
George Michael's Careless Whisper.
They'll be your new home, so get to know them. That'll be all. Report back in time for the briefing. Until
Squad
then,
7, roll out! But even though there's only one tank and most of you are going to be shock troopers because that's how much I care. Barracks. Who's in my
We got one of a purple worm playing the saxophone.
R.I.P. God damn it, I forgot these people. Largo's a pretty cool guy, and Rosie's a bitch. Hans.
Hondong.
Hondong's everyone's favorite.
Hans!
It's good to see you doing the rounds. Welcome.
I get how this goes, bitch. Get the fuck out. I get that's a rifle, that's a machine gun, that's a bazooka. But they call it a lance.
Changing gear. They can restock other units.
I get it, that's a sniper.
Let me see when the last time it was somebody actually sent us a wormhole message. I gotta go through all the sponge posting.
We need to find her. Where the fuck is she? She's not in here yet. No. She pretty cool.
Marina Wolfsten, at your command.
Okay, you're in.
My name is Dallas Wyatt. I'm excited to be joining up.
Hi there. I'm Yoko Martens. I'm sure we'll get along just fine.
My name is Susie Evans,
found the picture,
sir. I realize I'm inexperienced, but I'll do all I can.
Firmly grasp it.
The one where his nose is just 40 feet up.
I hate Kevin already.
I like how with one night of sponge posting, he went up like two levels.
I mean, wouldn't you do that?
Alex Raymond, I look forward to serving with you, Welkin.
Who are you people? Why are you in my house?
My name is Cesare Regard, and I'll handle things my own way, thank you.
Looks like I'm scroll up too far, and I see that Santa Claus is an illegal immigrant.
Of course you have.
I'm just trying to find where the last wormhole message was.
Oh.
Hello, I'm Claudia Mann. I'll do my best to live up to your expectations.
Which I have done for you. All right, then.
Can it be?
I'm Wendy Cheslock. Kaboom.
I can't wait till I'm able to recruit my waifu.
The name's Nina Strice, and I look forward to a good workout out there.
The name's Jane Turner. I'll do anything if it means putting holes in imps.
Okay, so the last wormhole message that we got was from Dom saying, "Diet Sprite, more like Diet 7-Up TBH."
True.
I'm Nancy DeFore. It's so good to meet you.
You know Corrin, reporting for duty. Looks like I'll be joining you in Squad 7.
Bueno.
Is it seeing my messages?
My name's
or do you
Ramona
have Discord open on the side?
I have Discord open on the side.
Okay. So you see my boy, Anna?
Hey there. I'm Ika Thompson. I'll try my best. Sound good, Welkin?
All these people are either really dickish and saying like, oh, I'm gonna do things my own way, or they're like, I'm happy to be here. And I'm just here like, I don't give a damn about any of you.
Feel like you've struck a bell.
The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
Coughing.
Wow. The Pokemon?
Coffee. Weezer.
Sorry.
Welcome to your worst night.
Still, oh god, the drill instructor. I hate him so much. He has a kick-ass eye patch, though.
Oh, look who's there.
It ain't complicated. First you go out there and fight. Then divvy up that experience here. Use for tears.
You heard that, Joe? There are no use for tears.
Only fears.
Sometimes
Joe.
Here. As long as we're talking about it.
Are you gonna watch Lucha or NXT tonight?
It doesn't The soldiers will get
Lucha.
Alright, because NXT is supposedly having a 2-hour special tonight about their their tour Japan.
The Japan tour.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll probably watch it as well tonight, because why not?
Yeah. We need to do our end of the year special.
Yes, we sorry do. About him, Lieutenant. With he's special like this guests. All the time, I'm afraid.
Ghost. And maybe Ty Lopez.
So, we do.
True.
I'm trying to get him on so he can be very with confused rifle. About our wrestling.
You won't have to worry. For tanks, you can upgrade the baseline performance of the. Come in any.
Tom Coughlin is being interviewed Wednesday as the head coach of the Jaguars.
What?
Do you know who Tom Coughlin is?
Nope.
He was the coach of the New York Giants for a long time.
Oh.
And now he's being interviewed for the Jaguars because the Jaguars are garbage.
Aren't they all?
I mean, I said they were.
I mean, did you? This has nothing to do with anything, but. But did you ever? Did you see that game that they had in Mexico?
Yes. Well, that was Oakland and Houston.
Yeah. But I mean, like, did you actually like see it and like laughed a little?
Yeah, I watched it live. It was a Monday night game, so I had to watch it.
Oh. But nobody cared in Mexico.
I wasn't sure who was going to get more of a home field welcome, considering that Houston is closer, but Oakland has quite the population to it.
But nobody cared.
Of course not. Everyone was just taking pictures. It's like when they have the games in England.
Here you... Well, sir,
expand
was that helpful?
Dong.
Faith. Said expand dong.
Book mode. Book. We need more books.
Booker! King Booker!
Was I the only one who marked out when King Booker made his on-screen return?
No, everyone marked out.
But then when the fashion police showed up, I'm like, hey, Booker, can you just...
I was sad that Charmelle wasn't there.
If she was there, I would have actually, like, enjoyed it more.
Hear ye, hear ye. All rise for the honorable King Booker.
I mean, she did have a WrestleMania moment making out with the Boogeyman.
So, this was last year or the year before or something like that. When the Pope was coming to Philadelphia.
Yeah.
Do you remember when that was in the news?
Yeah.
So 6ABC was doing the thing like, make sure you stay tuned at 11 and we'll give you details on how to see the Pope. And they were playing music in the background. And it was King Booker's music. They used King Booker's music for the Pope. That's how you know, dude.
I mean, isn't...
It's like when you're watching that one episode of Tosh.0 and it's like walking around the city with money in your pocket. And they start playing the Hardy Boys music in the background?
Yes. I mean, I think by this point, most of that music's now royalty-free.
Jim Johnston just didn't feel like holding the rights.
No, WWE owned most of the rights, and when he left, they were like, hey, we don't need this music anymore.
He didn't leave. He got relegated. Like, he just...
My game froze.
And I think now.
My game crashed.
Oh, hubba bubba. Hubba That's Bubba so Max. Raven. Okay, Saul, tell me if you remember this. Yes. So, years and years ago, when LeBron James was still a rookie,
Sega.
He did a deal. I heard Sega. He did a deal with Bubblicious Bubblegum to put out a pink lemonade flavored of bubblegum. Do you remember this?
I remember it vividly.
I still have the poster of that.
Good.
Let me.
No! All my progress. No!
Press F to pay respects.
You know what? I'm ending the stream right now. I'm actually pretty pissed off right now.